Hi dear students, welcome to our next class of computer networking. Today we are going to discuss about lot of networking devices which we are used in the field of computer networking. As we all are familiar with a lot of networking devices nowadays, that is a modem, NIC, that is network interface card, switches, hub, bridges, routers, gateway, and so on. So we will discuss each and every one in details. The first one is modem. What is modem? Modem is nothing but the short form of modulation and demodulation, right? It's a networking device which converts the digital signal to analog signal and the analog signal to digital signal. That is the function of a modem. With the help of this modem, we are connecting our computers to internet. Next device is network interface card. Network interface card is a device that is attached to each of the workstations and the server and helps the workstation establish the all important connection with the network. NIC is also called as Terminal Access Point, TAP, Terminal Access Point, and it is also termed as Network Interface Unit, NIU. As we all are having an address, the NIC manufacturer also assigns a unique physical address to each NIC card. And this physical address is known as the MAC address, MAC, MAC. It means Media Access Control Address. So MAC address is the address which refers to the physical address assigned by NIC manufacturer. A MAC address is a 6-bit address with each byte separated by a colon. Of these 6 bytes, the first 3 bytes represents the manufacturer ID and the last 3 bytes represents the card number that is assigned by the manufacturer. Next networking device is Wi-Fi card. A Wi-Fi card is either an internal or external local area network adapter with a built-in wireless radio or antenna. Another networking device is hub. A hub is a networking device which is used to connect several computers together. Mainly two types of hubs are there, that is passive hub and active hub. The active hubs electrically amplifies the signal as it moves from one connected device to another, whereas the passive hub allows the signal to pass from one computer to another without any change. That's the major difference between the active hub and passive hub. Another networking device is switch. A switch is a device which connects multiple communication lines together. It is used to create temporary connection between two or more devices linked to switch. Switches and otherwise known as an intelligent hub. Another networking device is bridge. A bridge is a device that lets you link two networks together. Bridges are smart enough to know which computers are on which side of the bridge, so they only allow those messages that need to get to the other side to cross the bridge. So bridge is responsible for filtering the data. Another networking device is a router, a device that works like a bridge but can handle different protocols is known as a router. A router is a networking device that forwards data from one network to another. A router works like a bridge but can handle different protocols. Another networking device is a repeater. A repeater is a networking device which connects different LAN segments. In other terms, we can define a repeater as which is a device used for amplifying the signals. Another networking device is gateway. A gateway is a device which connects dissimilar networks. That is, it establishes an intelligent connection between a local network and external network with completely different structures. Next one is access point. An access point, also called as wireless access point, WAP, is a hardware device that establishes connections of computing devices on wireless LAN with a fixed wire network. Here, wireless routers can function as access points, but not all access points can work as routers. That's the main characteristic change in wireless routers and access points. These all were some of the commonly used networking devices in the field of computer networking. Next, we are moving to another topic, that is the cloud. Nowadays, we all are familiar with the new term, this cloud computing. What do you mean by cloud computing? This cloud is a generic term used for internet. The cloud computing is an internet-based computing whereby shared resources, software, and information are provided to computers and other devices on demand, like the electricity grid. That's here, everything is stored in the server itself. There are different types of clouds, like private clouds, public clouds, community clouds, and hybrid clouds. First one is private cloud. These are the clouds for exclusive use by a single organization and typically controlled, managed, and hosted in a private data center. Public clouds are the clouds for use for multiple organizations on a shared basis and hosted and managed by a third-party service provider. Third one is community clouds. These are the clouds for use by a group of related organizations who wish to make use of a common cloud computing environment. For example, branches of military, all the universities in a given region, so and so. Next one is hybrid cloud. It's when a single organization adopts both private and public clouds for a single application in order to take advantages of the benefits of the both. It is known as hybrid cloud. Our next topic is Internet of Things. IoT is nothing but connecting our smart devices to the internet with wired or wireless network. Nowadays, in our house, almost all the equipments are IT enabled, that is software enabled. We are having smart watches, smart refrigerators, smart TVs, and so on. These all were connected to the internet through RFIDs, that is radio frequency identification tags, then sensors, smart technologies, softwares, and efficient network connectivity. Some of the devices that can form IoTs are home appliances such as fridge, cookies, coffee makers, heaters, TVs, DVD players, so on, so and so. Wearables such as clothes, shoes, hats, watch, hard mounties, etc., etc. Then nowadays, almost all the vehicles are using this kind of IoTs, that is cars, buses, everything is equipped with the IoTs. In factories, machines, robots, warehouse, shelves, parts within machines, tools, etc. are internet connected. In agriculture sector, smart farming is there, climate monitoring and forecasting, crop monitoring is there, and sensors for monitoring the conditions of food are also there. So almost all fields are connected to internet nowadays. Along with all these advantages, lot of risk and challenges are there. The most important and critical challenges and risk is the security of IoT. Like other networks, cyber attacks, hackers, and unauthorized intruders can attack IoTs as well, which is the great disaster in this era. So dear students, these were all about the networking devices, cloud computing, IoT, and the various risks and challenges in the field of IoT. Hope you enjoyed the session. In our next session, we will discuss about the modulation techniques such as amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, and so on. So thank you all my dear students. Have a nice day.